Here's why and how Apple is preparing to replace the iPhone. I'm serious. Exactly how in 2007 they killed off the insanely successful iPod in favor of something they felt had a way bigger potential, that same process is about to happen again. But what will replace the iPhone and subsequently smartphones in general, to me, is pretty obvious. It's smart glasses. In this case, the Apple Glass, as everyone has been calling them. And today, let me show you how I think they will be, both in terms of hardware and software. The smartphone is a device that defined the last decade. It changed the world in so many different ways. Obviously, it won't be easy at all to convince everyone to adapt to this new kind of device. But contrary to what many have said, I think Apple has a ton of reasons for letting this transition happen. The most important being that smartphones are getting boring. It's something that pretty much everyone in this industry agrees on. Smartphones, as a concept, have peaked. Almost everything that could have possibly been added or improved is already there. There's increasingly less reason for people to upgrade every year, and the data we have on upgrade cycles pretty much reflects that. Sure, the money is still coming for now, mainly thanks to various adjustments to the business model, but that won't work forever. Eventually, they need to move on from smartphones. Eventually, they need to create the next big thing. Something so new and innovative, people will be excited to buy it. In my humble opinion, smart glasses are the perfect category of devices to fulfill this role. Yes, they introduce some problems, but I think I know how to fix them. The first one is aesthetics. You've probably already seen some smart glasses, like the Google Glass, or more recently the Unreal Light, or the ones from Oppo or Xiaomi, but notice something, they all look terrible. Smart glasses are something you have to wear, and not only that, something everyone will see, as they are on your face. They have to look as good as possible. Knowing Apple, they'd probably be able to make even a completely alien design that people would still want to wear regardless. But for this concept, I tried something safe. They basically look like ravens, which is actually how that leak from Jim Prosser said they will look like. But can ravens do this? The temples are removable, like Apple Watch bands. This is something I think itself a ton of issues. It could allow for the glasses to better match whatever you're wearing, which is definitely important for a wearable device. Not to mention, this idea would make Apple an insane amount of money, obviously. But most importantly, it would solve, or at least mitigate, one of the biggest problems these devices have. The battery. Ever complained about your phone not lasting a full day? Imagine if the battery was cut in half. That's still bigger than the battery that will fit inside the glasses. Battery life will definitely be one of the main issues of smart glasses in general, especially for the first models, and it's pretty obvious why. The batteries themselves won't be able to be that big because, remember, they need to fit inside glasses that have to remain sleek and light. For reference, the Oppo Air Glass, despite being way simpler than what I'm envisioning, only lasts about 3 hours with a full charge. Sure, because of how small they would be, probably wouldn't take that much to recharge them, but it still would be pretty annoying. What if you could just swap them? If the battery, or batteries, I guess, were contained inside of the swappable temples instead of the main body of the device, you could just swap them to continue using the glasses. Yeah, I know, it's not a perfect solution by any means, but it's definitely better than having a cable. Plus, unlike AirPods or other very tightly designed devices that you basically have to throw away as soon as the battery degrades too much, this problem here simply doesn't exist. But what is that thing on the temple, you may ask? Well, it's time to talk about software. The term smart glasses actually doesn't mean much. Many companies came up with their ideas and their concepts which look and function in completely different ways. Some are on the simpler side of the spectrum, like Focus by North or the Google Glass, and are pretty much just meant to show widgets. But some, like the Unreal Light, have way more complex UIs, because the products themselves are way more ambitious in their scopes. It's pretty obvious that only this second category has any chance at replacing smartphones, so I made a UI for a category of devices that barely even exists yet. See the weird stuff in the background? I didn't have enough budget, so please pretend it's the real world, okay? Anyway, this is how I think the UI should be. One problem with smart glasses is that the stuff they show you is overlaid on top of the real world. I mean, that's pretty much the point of augmented reality, but it can quickly become a problem if the UI covers too much of your view. When you use a phone, or a tablet, or basically every other kind of display, you're fully concentrated on the content of the display. But if something else draws your attention, you can simply just turn your head and focus on whatever that was instead. But if we try to use this type of UI with smart glasses, it doesn't work. The UI would follow you around and continue to obstruct your sight. The solution I came up with is very simple. The majority of the elements of the UI should be placed at the bottom of the screen and should take up as little space as possible, while still remaining readable, obviously. Stuff like the massive headers in iOS would have no reason to exist here. The only exceptions being this bar with the usual basic info, which will always sit at the top, the place where it won't really be able to cover anything important regardless, and the actual apps that should be allowed to use the display at its full potential. And to minimize this problem even more, the glasses could have a feature where, if they detect a rapid movement of the head, the UI simply disappears. Anyway, the individual elements of the UI have a solid background, so that they contrast with the real world. Because while watching reviews of the OG Google Glass, I discovered that not being able to read the content of the display was an actual issue. Basically, the users would almost automatically try to find an uniform surface just to do that one simple task. Not exactly a great experience. But in my concept, only the element you have selected should be 100% opaque. The other should be semi-transparent, again, to cover as little as possible of the user's view. That thing on the temple is the equivalent of the iPhone side button, by the way. But if that is not some sort of touchpad or slider, how does the user navigate the UI? Every company came up with a different method of controlling their smart glasses. Some place that touch-sensitive surface on the temple, which I imagine would get annoying very quick, and also very difficult to use in crowded places. Some others wanted you to use pointers or some kinds of external controllers. But I think the most logical solution is this. A ring. One of the main advantages of smart glasses over smartphones is that the former can be hands-free, but if you have to use an external controller, that's no longer the case, obviously. The ring, though, could still allow for touch-based gestures, but it would always be with you. The gestures I have in mind are very simple and theoretically usable for anything. A swipe in any direction that starts from any point inside the circle is just a regular swipe to move inside of the context you're already in. Swipes that begin from outside the circle are for the actual gestures. A downward swipe opens the notification center, an upward swipe opens the multitasking, a swipe from the right opens the control center, and a swipe from the left is just a universal gesture for going back in the UI. And what about scrolling, zooming, or basically moving something along an axis? Well, some ideas never die, I guess. For the Apple Glass to replace the iPhone, it's fundamental that pretty much everything a phone can do must also be possible on the glasses, and that's why I designed the UI to be like this. Now comes the most important part, I guess. Why would anyone buy this stuff? I've already established that companies, in this case Apple, but even Meta and all the other ones, have all the interest in getting people excited for something new all over again. But what is the advantage to the user? Well, it's AR. Augmented reality as a technology is incredibly cool. You can already try some apps that make a really good use of it. Apple itself has been trying to push it for a while now, but there's one massive problem. You have to hold your phone like this. It's incredibly annoying having to hold something to experience AR. It doesn't feel like that stuff is appearing inside of your world. It feels like you're holding a window that lets you see the AR stuff. It fundamentally limits immersion, and it simply doesn't work that well. AR glasses are the solution to this problem. So, are we all going to ditch our phones next year? Absolutely not. I've dedicated a ton of time for this single concept. It's the most complex project I've ever done on this channel by far. But I know it's not perfect. There's still a bunch of problems I don't know how I'd fix. And even the real Apple Glass, whenever they get announced, will not be perfect the first time around. What I'm expecting is this. The Apple Glass will come out at some point. It may actually take a while between their announcement and the day they actually ship. And I'd say the first three generations will rely on an iPhone. They'll pretty much just be like the first Apple Watch. Also because I have no idea how could they really fit all the powerful hardware required for AR inside of thin and light glasses. From maybe the 40 iteration onwards, the main powerful chip still won't be inside the glasses themselves, but they will rely on something else, maybe a case or whatever, included with the glasses, obviously, making them not exactly an independent device, but at least an independent system. That will be the moment you'll be able to leave your phone at home. iPhones still won't be discontinued overnight this soon, but Apple will start to focus on them less and less. They'll still be selling them to people that aren't ready to make the switch, until people simply stop buying them. And then they'll disappear for good. I'm expecting either Apple or Meta to really standardize how AR glasses should be, and then everyone else will take inspiration. If you think what I'm proposing is just not something Apple will ever do, then watch this video next, as it'll show you why it actually perfectly follows their strategy and their formula for success. Ciao!